Dr. Harish, physiotherapist and ergonomist. This week we are going to see about comparative study and the effectiveness of hot fomentation and cold fomentation. Where to apply hot fomentation and which condition we have to apply for cold fomentation. And the scientific reason behind why we have to apply this two different types of techniques. So first we come out about the hot fomentation. When we apply hot fomentation, there is a scientific reason behind it. When you do a hot fomentation, there is a vasodilation, that is the blood vessel will dilate and there will be more blood flow to the affected part, that is the part where we are applying the hot fomentation. So because of this, there will be a soothing effect and a comfortable zone in the affected part, that is the injured part will have a comfortable zone and there will not be much healing process to that area. There will be only a comfortable zone because of the increased blood flow to the area and more oxygen supply to that area. There will be not much of a healing process to the muscle, only a blood flow will increase to that part. When we compare to the cold fomentation as a scientific process, that when you apply cold fomentation, that is the ice packs to the affected part, there will be vasoconstriction. The blood supply to the affected part, ice pack area will have a vasoconstriction, that is the blood to the affected part will be reduced, so that there will be feeling of a numbness. Because of that, the affected part will start to react by itself to repair the affected tissue with the WBCs and the fibrin cells, and there will be repair work taking place in the affected part. After you remove the ice fomentation from that part, there will be new blood flow rushing into the part because of the pressure variation. From high pressure to low pressure, the blood flow will be rushing to the affected part, which will be washing out the painful substances from the affected area, and that will give a better pain relief. And by doing cryotherapy, that is the ice fomentation, you will have a wound healing process also taking place in the affected part. So when comparing to the hot fomentation and cold fomentation gives a better result when compared to the hot fomentation. Here we have to use hot fomentation and cold fomentation comes here. So for cold fomentation, we can use it for the muscle spasm, neck muscle spasm. You have a low back pain, for low back muscle spasm or muscle strain, you can use it. For lateral ligament injuries, you have a slip injury in your foot, you can use the ice packs, that is cold packs. For any muscle cramps, you can use cold packs. And for any blunt injuries called contusion, you can use ice packs. And for conditions like tendinosis, like tennis elbow or tenosynovitis or a trigger finger, you can use ice packs. When compared to the hot fomentation can be used in for arthritis like joint inflammatory conditions, for swellings, for foot pain and heel pain, you can use hot water fomentation, that is putting a hot water in a tub with the hot water with rock salt into it. You can immerse your foot to the ankle level and it gives a better result for your pain relief in that heel and the foot level. So these are the areas you can use hot fomentation. So when it comes to the healing process, if you use in the wrong way, you will have a negative results. So keep that for each condition, it has to be kept at correct positions. Don't use ice fomentation for your some of the conditions where we use for hot fomentation, because that will have a counter reaction and it might aggravate your pain. So be careful when you are using ice fomentation. Thank you.
Thank you for sharing our videos. Like our Facebook page and follow us. Thank you. Our website is www.drharishphysio.com.